Hello from ChemHelp ASAP. We learned a formula for determining how many hybrid orbitals we need on an atom. That formula was A, the number attached to atoms, plus L, the number of lone pairs. And the sum of those two numbers, A plus L, gives us the number of hybrids that we need. I also prepared you when we talked about this formula that sometimes your lone pairs should not be included in that L value, or at least one of your lone pairs. We're now going to see an example where that takes place and try to understand a little bit about why that is. Okay, on the screen we have a molecule formamide drawn as a Lewis dot structure. There are three second row elements in this molecule. There's a nitrogen, carbon, and oxygen. Carbon and oxygen both follow all the rules that we expect, so we're not going to worry about those. It's really the nitrogen that we're interested in. So for the nitrogen, we would say the number of attached atoms equals 3. It's attached to two hydrogens and a carbon. The number of lone pairs equals 1, and so we would say A plus L equals 4. No problem. This would indicate that we need sp3. Hybridization, and we would expect the bond angle to be somewhere close to 109.5, and we expect the geometry to be trigonal pyramidal. And that's what we expect to see. So this is our prediction based on hybridization. What does the experimental data say? Because in the end, our prediction is only good if it matches with the experimental data. Well, as it turns out, the bond angle for that nitrogen is very close to 120 degrees. That's kind of confusing. And the experimental geometry of that nitrogen is trigonal planar. That's kind of confusing. If you look at this combination of bond angle, 120, and geometry, trigonal planar, this is all consistent with that nitrogen. Instead of being sp3, it is sp2. So, what's happening here? As it turns out, this is one of those cases where we exclude a lone pair from the hybridization model. And when I say a lone pair, as it turns out, the nitrogen only has one lone pair. But if we were dealing with an oxygen, we would only exclude one of the lone pairs. We'd leave the other lone pair in the hybridization count, this A plus L value that we had. So how do we learn to identify this? When do we apply this exception? Well, as it turns out, if you have a double bond, and off of that double bond is an atom with a lone pair, then this is a case where the lone pair gets excluded from your A plus L count. And as you can see in our molecule, up towards the top of the screen, in formamide, we have a double bond attached to an atom with a lone pair. So this is a case where we're going to exclude that lone pair. This is kind of a rare exception in the early stages of organic chemistry. But as we learn more and more organic chemistry, we will encounter more and more molecules that have this structural scenario where we have a lone pair next to a double bond. And we'll need to keep our eyes on that because that lone pair is excluded from the hybridization count. And therefore, it affects the geometry of that atom. Later, we'll learn more explicitly why this is and why the behavior of that lone pair is affected in such a dramatic way.